So Poco has just launched the 4G variant of the Poco M4 Pro, and while the 5G variant was released in November last year, in this video, I'll be letting you know what are the four key differences between this previous release and this particular variant, and why you should probably get this right now. But first, let's see what comes inside of the box. Now, in a typical Poco fashion, the box comes in yellow, and this time around, the model name Poco M4 Pro is written horizontally in front of the box instead, with the Poco logo at the top. Now, opening the box, there is a similar yellow box with the Poco logo on top as well, where you'll find the SIM ejector pin on the outside, the manuals, and a clear phone case. Then you'll immediately find the phone over there. Underneath, there's the USB A to USB-C cable. And finally, the 33W Pro fast charging brick. So the first differences between the 5G and the 4G variant is, of course, the design. And here is where we'll need to take a moment to appreciate how smartphone makers like Poco at least takes the effort of changing the designs of their smartphones, where a typical smartphone company would just leave it at the same exact design, and that was not the case when it comes to these two releases. Now, the design changes comes mainly for the camera arrays at the back, where there is now a rectangular shape and all of the camera lenses are not protruding at all, making the phone super sturdy when typing it on a surface or even when touching any part of the phone when it's on a surface. And another slight change is the headphones jack, where it is on top compared to on the bottom on the previous 5G variant, which I did like it better because it does separate itself when charging and listening to headphones on the phone at the very same time. And also worth mentioning is the fact that this new 4G variant is lighter at 179 grams compared to 195 grams for this 5G variant. Now, as for the second key difference would be the phone's display. Now, the obvious factor, of course, among everything, is the fact that we always use our smartphone looking at the phone's display. I mean, how else would you use the phone every day, right? And one of the many things that really stood out to me is, of course, the amazing AMOLED display on this new 4G variant compared to having an IPS LCD display on the previous 5G variant, making this the first ever AMOLED screen on any of the M series for the Poco smartphones. Now, upon turning on the phone, I could immediately see the better screen quality on the phone. Now, even though both phones comes with the same 90Hz refresh rate, there was a slightly better fluid and a smoother experience when navigating and scrolling around on this 4G variant. And because of this AMOLED screen, it has a higher brightness of 700 nits and also a peak brightness of 1000 nits, making it a great smartphone to use it in a brighter outdoor conditions. But of course, also really great when it comes to watching videos on the phone as well. Then with the SGS iCare display and the SGS seamless display, you are guaranteed to have an overall better experience when it comes to your eyes when using this phone every single day. Now, another usual reason why you would change your older smartphone to a newer one is, of course, the phone's cameras. And yes, this new camera arrays on this 4G variant has vastly improved, where we are looking at a higher 64MP f1.8 aperture lens compared to the previous 50MP lens. And besides having the same 8MP ultra-wide lenses, there's now an additional 2MP f2.4 macro camera. Hence, we are looking at a total of 3 lenses for this new 4G variant compared to just 2 on the previous rendition of the phone. And based on my quick test shots on this 4G variant, the images surely looks a little sharper and the overall image processing for the other lenses was great too, making it a very good phone to post on social media easily when it comes to the images. And also because of the front camera has a slightly better aperture value of f2.4 instead of f2.5, you'll find that the selfie images was also a tad bit brighter as well. Now, of course, I'm looking to test out these cameras more during my full video review, so subscribe to Adam Lobo TV if you haven't done so. As for the fourth differentiating factor of the smartphone is, of course, the memory or the storage options available in this new 4G variant. Starting from the RAM, what's new is that on top of the built-in RAM options that you get, there's also the dynamic RAM expansion support or the virtual RAM to make the phone's usability quicker than before. Now, while both phones has the micro SD card slot at the side to expand up to 1 TB, this new 4G variant comes with an internal storage option up to 256 GB, where the previous 5G variant only had a maximum option of going up to 128 GB. So you might not even need to go out and make a purchase of a micro SD card, because I always felt that 256 GB of storage was the sweet spot to store enough images, videos, or even apps. So you won't have that sort of anxiety of having your phone storage running out of space very quickly, as you could store up to 500,000 images with the amount of storage options available for this new phone. Now, if you're interested in the other specs of the phone, this new Poco M4 Pro also comes with a similar 5000 mAh of battery, but it includes the 33 watts Pro fast charging with the new MMT technology, which charges faster than other typical 33 watts fast charging. Where, as seen in the unboxing earlier, it does come inside of the box. Then the phone also has IP53 splash proof rating, dual speakers, and other smartphone essentials like the headphones jack as mentioned earlier. And of course, the IR blaster has also been included in this new variant as well. And when it comes to the software, it does come shipped with the new MIUI 13 with the Poco skin, but on top of Android 11. So with this, do let me know what you think, because guys, not everyone needs or every country has a proper support for 5G, which makes this new 4G variant a very compelling option out right now. But of course, do let me know what you would like to know about the phone, specifically at the comment section below, and either I'll reply to your comments down there, or I'll revert back to your comments during my full video review of the phone. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Adam Lobo, and I'll see you in my next video.